Also we find in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, punishments which are amazing. And I'm going to quote to you a hadith which perhaps you might have heard of, but you might never have thought that this was in about the grave. Once Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was asleep, and this is an authentic hadith in Bukhari, he was asleep, and he said, جاءني جبريل وميكائيل في منامي. Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam and Mikael alayhi salatu wasalam came to me in my dream. And he said, Intaliq, so let's move, come with us. We're going to take you somewhere. So the first thing that they took him to was a man who was on the ground. And the angel, and an angel had put his feet on the neck of the man and pinned him down like this. And then he had a big machete and he had a big fork. And with that he was ripping the side of his face until the back, until the whole face would come apart and blood would flow. And then he would start with the other side, and once he started with the other side, that face was being formed again. And the person was trying to get away, and the angel was pinning him down. So Rasulullah said, Ya Salam, Ya Allah, have mercy, who is this person? So the companion said, so the companions of Rasulullah, meaning the angel, said, move on. Then they went to the next person. Who was the next person? He was in an ocean of blood. And he was drinking the blood, and he was vomiting, and he was drowning in his own thing. And every time he tried to get out of it, an angel would throw a big boulder and he would push him all the way to the middle of the ocean. So he could never get out. Who is this person? Move on. This next person they came to was a man who was on the ground. And he was lying down on the ground, and an angel was taking a big mountain, a boulder the size of a mountain, and then crushing his head with it. Crushing his head with it. And Rasulullah said, Ya Salam, who is this person? Allah have mercy, who is this person? Move on. Then they came to another people who were in a big furnace, a big ditch in the ground, a big furnace, and they were naked in it, and fire was coming up from the bottom and burning them, and they're trying to get out and they couldn't get out. And as soon as they tried to get out, angels from the top would hit them and they would go down. Who are these people? Allah have mercy. And then now Jibreel alayhi salam and Mikael alayhi salam, they told Rasulullah who they were. The first person who their faces were being torn was a person who used to speak ghibah. How easy is it to speak ghibah? How easy is it to make ghibah? Let me tell you how easy it is to make ghibah. If you were to say about somebody, Ya haram, he doesn't have much money, that's ghibah. Do you understand that? Ya haram, don't we say that? Sometimes out of pity even. But we don't realize that we're actually making ghibah, because he might be the person doesn't want that to be known. Ya haram, he's going through so much difficulty with his family. Oh, so and so is so, you know, I feel so bad for him. You know, something like that, something even you intended good, it may actually be ghibah. It is for this reason why once a woman came into the hut of Aisha radiallahu anha, and then she was going out. So Rasulullah said, who came? At that point, Aisha didn't tell her name. She just said like this, meaning she's short. The short one came. And at that point, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ya Aisha, laqad kulti kalima. Wallahi Aisha, you have said a statement, even though she didn't say anything, but with the indication and the pointing with the hands, it was a statement that she made. لَقَدْ كُلْتِ كَلِمَةً, you've said a statement. لَمُزْدِجَ فِي مَاءِ الْبَحَرِ, if it was to be mixed with the oceans of the world, it would have لَأَفْسَدَتْهَا, it would have destroyed it. Ya Salam, imagine this. This is ghibah. That is worse in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than stealing. It's a worse crime in the sight of Allah than stealing. Also have a look. How easy is it to make ghibah? Wallahi, it's so easy, my friends, that we fall into it almost every day. So please do your level best. Other people's affairs are not your issues.
خفقات ما أحلاها بشرى تسقي مسعاها بتخرجنا نلقاها غنت فيها ألحانها.